the moment of time.
On second down, here's Newton. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play. And they'll be facing a third and 12.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Gotta credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
And a nice gain of 21 yards. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
It's a gain of five on the play, and it'll be second down.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive, he may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, two catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, that should open up his running game, too. That catch good for five. It's third down. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but four for four on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. The confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
Offense walks to the line for play number seven of the drive. Another run, this time McCaffrey. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33.
What position? And we just saw there some linebackers that can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. And a short gain down to about the 33. Just a yard there, so it brings up a tough third and 12.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Throwing on third down, Newton. Eluding the pressure right. He may try and run for this. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. Newton able to use those legs and get past the marker to pick up the first. So an instance there of Cam being Cam. We know he can use his legs.
And with that big body, it's hard to get him down, even if you get a clear shot on him. Plus, he moves it a lot faster than what people think. And boy, does he have fun playing the game of football.
It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense.
And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A great effort there, hitting double digits. The offense set to take the field here as they have the football in the final minute of this first quarter. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep them to short gains, make the fundamentals.
The Panthers on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and seven. From the gun, here's Newton. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down. And he was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here's away. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Newton. Looking left sideline, incomplete. They were looking to get it to Kelvin Benjamin there, and it's third down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Here's Newton. Gets it to Benjamin. It's caught. It'll be a gain of 16 and give him a first down as well.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works a defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
On the give, this is their fullback. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
That's someone who's pretty happy right there. That's the defense coordinator. Body after body getting to him before he can get started.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now.
Nice job there defensively on third down. Not only did they string the play out, but they didn't allow any room for a cutback. Really well organized on the defensive side.
Off play action, Newton. Blitz coming and down he goes. David Irving in there to drop him for a 4-yard loss, and it'll be fourth down.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. With a little over 2 minutes to play in the second quarter, the offense gets ready to take over. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Handoff as they run the counter play. And he's got this one just across midfield to the 49. A minute 59 to go in the first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. The Panthers on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This time it's 3rd and 3. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks, because no matter what, You really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Ezekiel Ansah coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8. And there they bring pressure from the inside, and they get home.
Yeah, hard to block everyone, isn't it? And on this play, someone did not get blocked. He's the one who got home.
And he's not even going to get back to the line of scrimmage. A loss of 1 yard, and it brings up 4th.
After a play like that, it should be congratulations all the way around, I think, because if you can stop a big fullback like that, that's not easily done.
Yeah, he does not go down easily. You're right, but he did there. And no, it doesn't get there. Hits the crossbar, bounces back out. So they surrendered 3 points, and now after the kickoff, this offense gets ready to take over the football. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. 23 yards on the play. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
The give to the fullback on the dive. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. They come out here in the eye. And they let the fullback try and take him home. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. This clearly the final play of the half, but no field goal attempt. They're going for it with 3 seconds remaining. And they'll turn to the power game to try to get in. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. It's the fullback. This offense ready to get back out there as they'll have the football to start the third quarter. Come the Panthers, they'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They built a good first half lead, now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. You have a guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
A good pick up there of 20 yards. We often, with Cam Newton, talk a lot about his legs. Don't forget about that arm.
He can throw it on a rope. He can loft it. He's got the touch that's been developed throughout his career. But the big part about just watching him throw it, it seems almost effortless.
And Olsen over the middle. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense, and reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. Now they'll run it on the toss. Able to fight for about 4 yards there to the 13.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Third and two, Newton. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. After a good punt, this offense will start with tough field position. Inside the 10. Carolina getting set to take the field. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Again, they run again. It's McCaffrey. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. Halfback sent in motion. The throw on second down is Newton. He's going to let this one go deep. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down.
And it is true, you can draft the fastest, you can draft the most athletic guys, but if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, he'll force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though, falls incomplete. Now a play fake, and it's Newton. Got his target, Samuel. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. A good pickup there, a 22.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 10 more there and another first down.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
Now a first down throw for Newton. And he's going to lose yardage here as they will switch ends as time has run out on this third quarter. It's the Panthers out in front and in control of the football as well as we begin quarter number four. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. There's Newton now on second down. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down. The Panthers on third down. They're hitting at 60%, 6 out of 10 thus far. This is third and 10. And he goes in motion here in the backfield. On third down, Newton. And he finds a man. It's McCaffrey. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll, in fact, tackle him behind the line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be second and 12.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
It's a loss of 2, now third down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now.
Rush coming, and he's taken down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And Elliott puts this one through. And that'll push the lead up to 17. Now following the field goal, what can this offense do? We're about to find out. Newton gonna hand it off to McCaffrey. And he'll get 4 here down to the 35-yard line. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives them a new set of downs.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Good gain there on first down. It keeps them in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front. Good blocking. Nice hole for him. Ends up picking up nice yardage. Stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively. They go play action here on first down. They'll drop it off to McCaffrey. A nice display of powerful running, but it takes him only to the 7. He's dropped there. It'll be a gain of 6, and it'll be a second down. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. On second down, McCaffrey. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more.
Tough day, tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. They come out here in the eye. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. Give him a gain of four, able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now. And quickly, they get to the line. On the ground, McCaffrey. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the three. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Offense working with a second and goal now from the three. McCaffrey, and he's going to ball his way in for a Panther score. A great play there with touchdown. Now following the interception, this offense will get another shot at it as they'll quickly head back onto the field. Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here and this game should be over.
It's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They stay on the ground, McCaffrey again. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Call it a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here. Third and a yard. Now a give, right side McCaffrey. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down to the 46. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. And this will likely be the last play and wrap things up. McCaffrey on the counter, and an alley to run. And he'll be taken down here, and that is how this one is going to come to an end. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter.
Stuck in my worldly ways. Propaganda press, pan the camera. Please don't look at me in my face. Everybody might see my pain. Off the rail, myself. Bored with life as aboard this plane. Steward this sex if I need help. Maybe